Of the show for today. We're talking to Dr. Leonard Maddu, and the topic is Cuba. And Dr. Maddu has given us some information relative to how the United States became involved with Cuba. And of course, Dr. Maddu, let's see if we can pick up at that mm-hmm. point and further develop our discussion on Cuba.
Yes, you know, because of the policies, you know, chosen by the Castro government, which was anathema to our own government, mm-hmm. you know, the Eisenhower administration, and subsequently, you know, the Kennedy administration, you know, started plotting to overthrow the Castro regime. Mm-hmm. This, you know, led to the infamous or famous Bay of Pigs invasion, mm-hmm. which in Spanish they call Bahia de Conchinos, you mm-hmm. know, Bay of Pigs. Mm-hmm. The invasion failed, of course. And after this, the Soviet Union, as then came in, Khrushchev was leader of the Soviet Union at that time, they came in to support Cuba. So they put in missiles, you know, mm-hmm. all around the island. This was a threat, of course, you know, to our government here. Mm-hmm. Kennedy, you know, upped the ante and said that the Russians should remove all the missiles. Otherwise, the U.S., you know, would not hesitate to attack, you know, Cuba. Mm-hmm. But after some negotiations, you know, Khrushchev, you know, had a quid pro quo. Mm-hmm. They will remove the missiles from Cuba mm-hmm. as far as we removed our missiles from Turkey.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
You know, this was agreed, and this calmed down the situation. Mm-hmm. And because of the embargo, you know, we imposed a big quarantine against Cuba, which exists up to today. You know, the Russians came in with about $4.4 to $5 billion a year to the Cubans in economic subsidies. You know, oil, food, you name it, imports and exports. This continued until 1991. You know, when the Soviet Union collapsed mm-hmm. and communism collapsed all over the world. Cuba was left lurching, you know.
Mm-hmm. High for, dry, you know.
Exactly, dry and completely mm-hmm. lost, you know. And so that has been a big problem since then, you know, since 1991 when this happened till, you know, now Cuba, you know, has lost all those economic mm-hmm. sustenance from the Soviet Union.
Good.
What happened was that because of that, the Castro regime started loosening some, you know, controls on its economy. Mm-hmm. Started allowing some little private enterprise here and there. And of course, Venezuela replaced mm-hmm. Russia as the main supplier of oil, mm-hmm. you know, to Cuba. Mm-hmm. And of course, that oil wasn't free. It's free, but then you have 20,000 Cuban healthcare workers in Venezuela working for that oil, mm-hmm. you know, to Fidel Castro. And just to touch a little bit on that Guantanamo Bay, you know, a lot of people always ask about it, you know, how did we get there? Why? Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, we took it over from the, you know, because of the Spanish-American War, mm-hmm. and signed a treaty in 1903, mm-hmm. you know, to pay a yearly, you know, amount to the mm-hmm. Cuban government mm-hmm. for that. But up to today, that check has not been cashed. We still pay Cuba every year to lease Guantanamo Bay.
We're still paying for that.
Yes, uh-huh. still paying for it. Yes, it's on lease, you know, legally. But Fidel Castro says he will never cash any of that check because it's blood money. So they keep piling the checks in Havana.
Okay, so they're not cashing the check, but we continue to pay the checks.
That's
and so that's it. And this is, so this is one of Castro's kind of things.
That's correct. We keep paying, but he's not cashing any of it. We have to leave Guantanamo Bay. He's not accepting a dime for it mm-hmm. because he believes it's blood money. Mm-hmm. Now, having said that,